Welcome back to Let Us Learn to Lead video series on free open source software designed by M. Srinivasan, Training Associate Mathematics, Kendra Vidyalaya Sangathan, Zonal Institute of Education and Training, Mumbai. Self-learning contents in video form on GeoGebra, dynamic mathematics software, is presented at this video series. To view the contents, you may join Google Classroom by using the class code 73AUMBO. In this video, you will learn designing worksheet to prove we cannot construct a congruent triangles when two sides and one non-included angle is given. Normally, we will call it as SAS criteria, telling that their angle should be an included angle between the sides. Suppose if two sides and one non-included angle is given, we are going to check whether congruent triangle can be constructed or not. For preparing this video lecture, I used Windows 10 operating system, licensed version, GeoGebra 5.0, a free open source software, and free open source screen recorder software. Let us start. Let me show you what type of worksheets we are going to prepare. We will tell them what do you mean by that SSA criteria. Congruent triangle cannot be constructed if two sides and one non-included angle is given. For that, I will take one triangle and let me try to have another triangle to be constructed making use of AB, AC and angle B, which is a non-included angle. I will measure them and I will try to construct it. When I try to construct it, I get two triangles. The two triangles are there, therefore congruence is not possible, I am going to conclude. Okay, the unit triangle not obtained. Okay, well, let us try to verify it using GeoGebra from scratch. For that, I have selected one GeoGebra 5.0 worksheet, geometry view, in the option rounding off to zero decimal place, and in labeling new points only. First, we will explain the children what you want. For in the ABC text, we will tell them that congruent triangle, SSA criteria. We will ask the children, is it possible? Okay, then we will tell them that it is not possible by making the following statement. Statement already I have typed it. Congruent triangle cannot be constructed if two sides and one non-included angle is given. Go to this ABC and then simply I'm pasting it, clicking OK. Well, now for that, let me take a triangle now from this polygon. Let me take a very small triangle A, B, C and A. Let me try to find out what is its side which is going on changing. For that, escape. I will select this segment and I will show its label only. I will select this segment and let me show its label only. I will take this angle B by putting it in a clockwise direction. Therefore, touch C. Touch C. Touch B and then touch A, you will get alpha as 59 degrees. Now you know that very well that when I am just moving it, it moves and it also changing, C changes, B changes, everything changes now. Okay, now I want to try this, that is let me try to construct another triangle using the sides. Actually already I have discussed in the previous wording that I want to take two sides and one non-included angle. For I am taking AB, I am taking AC and not angle A but angle B. Let us try. For that, let me go for this segment. Segment with the given length. I want a length of AB. Therefore, touch it. It will ask what length you want. You simply type C. Okay. Now, when I move this, you are seeing, escape. When I move this, that also moves. Okay. That also moves. There won't be any problem. Okay, now I want the same angle at B, the same angle at E also, or go for this angle with the given size. Touch this D, touch this E, immediately ask what angle you want. Delete it. Go from this, take alpha, alpha, and then do clockwise. That is okay. Now again, you go for this ray to get the ray of that particular angle. Okay, this angle you have got, escape. Now, when I move this, you are seeing that also changes now. Now I have to find out where this f will be there. For that I will remove this object. Okay, well, now this is 46 degrees and this is E and this is E. For that I want from D f, if you want, that also equal to B. Therefore, let me go for a circle with the center and radius. Here I just simply touch it. I will go for the radius as small b. I'm clicking OK. Oh, it is touching at 2 points now. If you want to show it very clearly, you see, it is touching at 2 points somewhere. Okay. Now let us go for this point of intersection. Touch this and touch this. You will get 2 points of intersection. Now you can remove this circles now. This circle, show the object. Okay, sorry. Okay, I can show the object, and then now you are having 2 points now. Now you will add 2 triangles now. I will go for the first polygon, D, E, F, and then D. Triangle number 1. Triangle number 2, D, E, and then G, and then D. Okay, I got 2 triangles now. Now I escape, and then this can be removed now. Okay, well, now when I move it, I'm just also moving now. You see, you are getting 2 triangles. The triangle is not unique. Therefore, you have not constructed a congruent triangle now. If you want to get all the angles, that's one way of doing it. You can click this angle and then click it. 2 times it will come. Click it. 2 times it will come. Click it. It will come. Okay, automatic. Okay. Now, you are seeing here that this angle, if you want, just you can show this angle also in clockwise direction. D, F, and then D. Okay, now you are getting 102 degrees. Okay, this is not actually congruent with the original triangle now. Therefore, we cannot construct congruent triangle when two sides and one non-included angle is given to us. For the child can understand that, what is the speciality of that SAS, included angle condition to get congruence. Thank you. Let us learn to lead.